This video is on the circuit board design aspect. If you're more interested in the PCB manufacturing aspect, you can click here now, or watch this video and click the link at the end.
I figured I'd make a video about how I do my projects. Instead of just showing you what I've done, I'll show you the process I normally go through to make it. So I saw this LCD on eBay. The reason behind why I purchased it will become evident in a later video, and I wanted to interface with it. So I bought the LCD without looking twice at the datasheet. Actually, I didn't even look once. And it has this ribbon cable connector on the end here. And they gave me this convenient little ribbon cable connector to the PCB thing. So let's see if I wanted to make this display something from USB on the computer, like the computer controls what's on the LCD, how would I do it?
So for this part, I'm using KiCad, and I've sped it up, I believe it's around 100 times. The first part is I lay down the processor. I'm using an ATmega 328, and then I go look up the data sheet to see what the reference is for the power. Because the part uses 3.3 volts only, I need to configure the AVR to be a 3.3 volt AVR. As you can see, it also needs an external crystal and all the basic parts like a programming header. Now I'm adding the USB stuff, which I'm taking from another reference document that I've made for myself. All of these things just go together kind of based on other designs that I've done in the past. That's why it's so quick. If you have to start from scratch, it's not that bad, but you get faster at it as you go. Here I'm looking up the data sheet for the LCD, trying to figure out exactly which pins go where and how to hook it up, and I'm just copying their existing reference design again. Very little of this is my own work, and that's generally the way that most engineering goes, is that you just try to figure out, well, if I'm going to do what other people do because it works, how would I go do that? So you can see I'm just wiring it up in the same way that their reference diagram has set up for me. Now I'm just kind of going back in and doing some housekeeping and making sure I select all of the footprints correctly for all of the parts. Additionally, because this uses an FPC that I've never used before, I have to lay out a new design. So this new design is done in the KiCad editor, and it's pretty simple. You just pull open the thing and you start, you know, you'll need a calculator to figure out how to place parts, place little pads. But once you do, you get a pretty good idea as to where everything goes, and then you lay out the pads, and now this is a footprint for the new FPC part. I actually messed up and got the pins backwards, so you see it takes a little bit longer than you'd hope. But overall, it works out. So now I'm putting all the parts down kind of in a rough idea on the page. Because I'm doing this on one layer, I have to be kind of careful with the orientation and the setup of all the parts. I can't have vias. So you gotta be really careful about how these things line up. Additionally, because this part uses such fine pitch, I have to use different tolerances and set things up in different ways than I normally do. Now I'm going to have to move it over to TopoR. In order to do this, you export from KiCad and you open it up in TopoR. This helps you lay out the board. Unfortunately, the first time through, it basically always will demand that you have some vias, so you have to play with the parts. Try to get it to work without any vias. And that's just kind of an iterative process. Just keep going over and over and over it. Sometimes you have to play around with the pins, which pins hook up where. Sometimes you even have to abuse some of the pins, make some of the pins route through the wrong places in order to get this to work. But in general, most designs I do, I can figure out a way of getting it down to a single layer. I used to do this all manually, but TopoR is about as good as I am, so I figure why waste the effort? As you can see, just tweaking it, trying to get the parts closer together, and trying to play with the settings to get the layout that I want is a pretty time-consuming process, trying to pull it back in. As you can see here, I decided I wanted a new part. I wanted to be able to put a different header on in case I wanted to interface to other things. This is an I2C header I use. And then I just add it to the schematic, add it to the layout, try to fit it in a way that will still fit on one layer, and then I go give it to TopoR again. And again and again and again, cycling through TopoR, trying to play with it, give myself as best tolerance as possible, and trying to keep it all on one layer. So a lot of just competing things. You got to play with it a lot to really get it quite right. It took me probably a month or two to learn how to use TopoR effectively. But overall, I'm very happy with it, and here you can see I'm just adding in some artwork, some text, some guides so I know which pin is one and whatnot to make the process easier. And yeah, this is just about there, adding in the ground plane, and we are good to go. Now I'm going to export it as a PostScript file so that I can import it. Some purists out there will say, oh, you need to leave it as vector, but no, I just use 600 dpi. That's plenty good. I import it with anti-aliasing because the laser printer supports that. And I invert the colors and flip it left for right. And that's because you want the artwork side to be as close to the copper as possible.
Thanks for watching how I design my circuit boards. Now, if you want to see how they're actually made, you can go click the link right here to follow on to the next video.